Why is this map so important for UPSC preparation? First, let me tell you. Why is this map so important? When I say map, I am telling that copy of Atlas which you are having in your hand. Atlas is nothing but the comprehensive compilation of maps of different countries, different continents, different physical, political features on the surface of the earth. Correct? What is Atlas? It is a comprehensive compilation of maps of different countries, different continents, plus physical and political aspects of things which are on the surface of the earth. That is what I am telling map. Map means I am not speaking about the outline map. Map means here I am not indicating about the Indian map. I am saying map as a whole. I am telling map reading means understanding the atlas. Why it is important? Now you see, the UPSC I told you we are not going to do in one time. It requires long time. So in this long time, why it is requiring long time means so much data has to be accumulated. So much. You are reading history in one corner, modern Indian history. You are reading geography, Indian geography in another corner. Then you are reading polity in some other aspect. Then you are trying to understand about economy, science, current affairs. You tell me, all they are divergent or they are same? You just give me an understanding. They are all divergent or they are all same? Modern Indian history you are reading. Then you are reading about Indian geography. First, are they same or different? Just today morning, one of the students asked me, sir, how history and geography are same, sir? He asked me a question. Happens to be an history student. That's why he asked this question. Okay. Then I told him, in Indian history, do you ever know Alauddin Khilji had never crossed Vindhya mountains in the south? Yeah, he said, yes, yes, I know. He concentrated only north of Vindhya mountains. Do you know any reason for this? He said, yeah, sir, slightly I am knowing, but right now I cannot say. I said the reason is geography. Do you know Muhammad bin Tughlaq? Yeah. He came up to the southern part of India. He came up to Ramnathapuram, Ramnath. But still he could not keep his empire intact. Do you know the reason? No. That's also result of geography. Do you know Hitler? Yeah, sir. We all know Hitler. Why did he lose in the Second World War? Geography. Sir, do you know Napoleon the Great? We'll be, maybe if time permits, I'll speak one or two things. Napoleon. So that also is not, he is not reaching. That's also because of geography. So the point I am telling is each and every subject which we are studying is not studied to be in isolation. It is not supposed to be studied in isolation. First, remove from your mind the myth that they are all are different. No, they exist in unison. History, geography, polity, economy, everything existed together. Only recently in the mankind, 100 years back or so, we decided that I want to study only this aspect. Everything existed in the nature together. But I am going to study only this part as separate. So I have taken that part to be history. This part as separate, that I have taken as geography. Another part as separate, I have taken as polity or whatever it is. But everything is existing same. You cannot be reading history without knowing geography. You cannot be understanding polity without understanding history or geography. You cannot be knowing economy well unless you know all the three which I have said. Current affairs, you will not know unless you know the background or backing of all the things which I have said. In paper one, if it is asked in history, you just understand the points of history, you write. And if it is asked in paper one in geography portion, same. Urban development and planning, is it a geography topic, current affairs topic, or what topic is this? Environmental topic. Urban development and planning. You tell me. It is an environment topic or geography topic or what? Is it a polity topic? Is it an economy topic? You are developing an urban center. Urbanization means geography says there is a separate unit in settlements. So urbanization is geography. One person is telling, sir, when you are developing geography, suddenly urban cannot develop in an urban area. So at one place a rural city developed, then township, then urbanization. So environment is involved. You are destroying some environment. Sir, this is environment, sir. This is a subject associated with environment. A crisis is happening during the time that is associated with current affairs. Now, when development of urban center is done, of course, money is to be spent for the development. You have to borrow money from one bank, another bank in the world, and invest money either from the government or by some other agency. Now, this is economics. And finally, you are not constructing the project on time. You go to the court for the settlement. Quality is involved. Yes or no? First, you understand this fundamental. Okay. So, once you understand this fundamental, you will not be having any problem. Okay. So, geography has to be known first. Why? Because we have to build other subjects based on it very efficiently, effectively. It is just a basement. Then gradually, one by one, things can be built. First, I have to build India as a political boundary. In this India, I have to incorporate all the mountains. Himalayan mountains, Vindhyas, Satpura, all I have to include. Rivers, plateaus, plains, islands, everything has to be included. Then only it had become an India. From then on only I am going to write history. Then I am going to write. From then I am going to write polity. Then I am going to speak about national struggle. Everything is afterwards only. First, you understand this? First. So, understanding map is an essentiality because it's the very foundation of understanding anything. Secondly, when you are trying to decipher so many informations which is existing, there is a possibility that you can forget all this information. It is a possibility. It is possible. You are studying about an earthquake somewhere, an aircraft has crashed somewhere, and cyclone had hit some other area. So there is a possibility that since you are an UPSC aspirant, all these informations are coming and bombarding you in your head every day morning. And there is a possibility that you will forget. And how to recollect and remember this data is when you store this data in the mind, you use the aid of the atlas, then you store the data, the possibility of you forgetting becomes less. I am not telling that you will remember everything. I am telling that you will interconnect the data and remember the data for a longer duration of time. Studying about Indian geography without map and studying Indian geography with map makes a lot of difference. Map you throw away just to study about the Himalayas? No. Things go in your mind. It is an imaginative mind. It is not a real mind. So, map is required because you have to remember the data for a longer duration of time. First, you understand this? It is required. Thirdly, a success in UPSC of a candidate depends on his comprehensive understanding and accumulation of knowledge rather than his partial knowledge. A question is being asked to you in the interview or in the mains about any one specific topic. And if you give one dimension, unidimension, you will score less marks. An UPSC aspirant is supposed to know many things and take one final decision, not many decisions. You cannot take one good decision without knowing many aspects of the same thing in different dimensions. And you take one decision and say, this is the best decision. If I ask you, what are the other possibilities you have seen? No, sir, just one angle I have analyzed. In this angle, this is the best decision. Then that decision is not correct. So in the mains answer writing, your answer would be enriched once you have an understanding of many issues which are comprehensive in nature. Means all this, when you are comprehending, when you are giving that answer in the mains, that has got a different dimension. That is the difference between what it makes between a person who scores that 10% to 7% extra mark than the person who is not clearing means. It is not a test of just memory. It is a test of understanding. Purinchala? And the understanding ulukku eppadi 360 dimension, comprehension, idala yappa varonna, yella visithi patti or alavukku information irundhala varon. Adukkagum map mukhyam. Geography optional students ku the map pathi or vishayatha solren, but without mastering map, don't you ever think you will score high marks in that particular subject. For the optional students I am telling, only hard work and smart work pays. So map is essential because you can score directly from the map questions which is being put to you. You understand this? And one more additional point. When you get service and the knowledge of the map is going to help you tremendously from those people who have just passed this examination with less information about the map. So you are going to have an edge over the others, those with the knowledge of geography, maps, map geography, and those without, you are going to definitely have an edge. So map is the fundamental second aspect. This is all importance of map. Let us go. Second, my point is that, sir, if it is so important, what is that we can do? What is that you have to do? I am giving you one or two simple measures wherein which you can have an interest and advancement over this map. First, buy one atlas. Second point, that atlas has to be placed in your everyday table when you are reading the newspaper. Whenever you read the newspaper, atlas has to be constantly present. You just keep three books when you are reading the newspaper. I am telling for the students who really wanted to clear. One atlas. Second, PM Bakshi Polity. That's all the article book is there, but you do not have to keep every day. Just you got to keep side where we, sometimes when you have some doubt. Third, dictionary you have to keep. Normally when you read the newspaper, I am telling. One dictionary of your choice, small dictionary you can keep. Fourth, you need to have a note to jot down some points. When you read the newspaper, keep one note for note making. Secondly, keep one atlas, 100% necessary. If you see any one location, foreign country, let us say, you see Crimea, let us say peninsula which is having lot of problem, Crimea, often the news is coming. First you stop the newspaper and find where is this Crimea. Adikadi newspaper vandute irukudhu engannu kandupidinga first and atlas la poittu. Adu Asia la irukudha, Europe la irukudha, illa enganachu vera enganachu irukudha. First you find it out. It is essential that you have to find it out, and once you see that location, just your location Crimea, konjam ஒரு 5 செகண்ட்ஸ் 10 செகண்ட்ஸ் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா எடுத்து அது பக்கத்தில் இருக்கிற நாடை மட்டும் பார்த்துக்கோங்க. டோன்ட் மக் அப், ஜஸ்ட் லுக் அரவுண்ட். கோ டு திஸ் கிரீமியா, லுக் அபான், யூ சி ரஷ்யா. யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? அண்ட் லுக் அரவுண்ட் வாட் யூ சி. நோட் ஆல் திஸ் திங்ஸ். டோன்ட் ரைட் இன் த மைண்ட், இட் வில் ஸ்டே இன் த மைண்ட், இட் வில் ஸ்டே. டோன்ட் யூ அண்டர்எஸ்டிமேட் யுவர் பொட்டன்ஷியல், இட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு ஸ்டே இன் யுவர் மைண்ட். And whenever any other location, any city's name is coming, any Olympics, any terrorist attack, infiltrations, meetings, conventions, you understand all this? Any island which is environmentally disturbed, any one place which has been affected by a natural hazard, see that in the map. When you see the things in the map, you will remember it for a longer duration of time, and you will be understanding. At one point of time, you are going to make a connection. That day, you saw one earthquake happening around Java Island. Another day, you happen to see a natural disaster happening beneath the earth near Andamans. Then you are going to see an earthquake which is of slight tremor happening in Arunachal Pradesh. Next, you are going to see that is happening in Pakistan region. Next, it may happen in a city in Iran. Next, the earthquake may be some other place. It will be in Mediterranean. Now, when you connect all this, this is nothing but intercontinental belt. What intercontinental belt? Tectonic active intercontinental belt. These are the places where the earthquake and the volcanic activity should happen actually. And these are happening not out of random, but there is a connection. Without these connections, if you simply read, you cannot put everything together. Are we understanding this first? Whenever you try to focus the areas affected by a cyclone in India, you are seeing this Tamil Nadu, northern part of Tamil Nadu is affected by this Nada. This northern part of Tamil Nadu is affected by this cyclone. Then Odisha is affected by this. Then a doubt may come to you, why only the cyclones are affecting this one part? If you constantly see the map, that doubt will come. பிகாஸ் எல்லாம் பார்த்தா ஒரு சைடே அஃபெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு. எப்படி இது? How is it possible? Then possibly probable questions will arise in your mind that why not other side? UPSC is going to put the same question to you. Now when you prepare this in some scientific manner, this UPSC preparation, preparation of UPSC is scientific. It is not rudimentary. Scientific, then you anticipate the question well in advance in the mains. These are the questions he is going to ask. Sir, this is 2017 Champaran Satyagraha, 2018 it is going to come, 2017-18 associated to Champaran question had come in the mains. 100 years. யோசிக்கணும் எதனா சொன்னேன். இப்படி வருமா பாசிபிலிட்டிஸ்? யா. Only when you make all these connections, may your preparation will be different from these people who are simply reading NCERT from the first page to the last page. நீங்களும் அதெல்லாம் பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க, NCERT first page to last page. அந்த எட்ஜு என்ன? யூபிஎஸ்சி ஸ்டூடெண்ட் சொல்றான்ல சார் ஒரு எச்சு எங்களுக்கு வேணும் சார் அப்படின்னு, அந்த எஜ் தான் அது. வாட் ப்ரிடிக்டிங்? அந்த ப்ரிடிக்ஷன் வில் ஹேப்பன், நாட் தட் யூ வில் டெல் டு அதர்ஸ் இதுதான் ப்ரிடிக்ஷன் நீங்க சொல்ல மாட்டீங்க, ஆனா உங்க மைண்ட் வில் நோ தட் ஒய் திஸ் இஸ் நாட் ஹேப்பனிங். ஸோ ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி வென் யூ ரீட் ஜியோகிராஃபி ஃபார் த நெக்ஸ்ட் டைம் யூ வில் பி ட்ரைங் டு ஃபைண்ட் த ரீசன் ஒய் சார் ஒன் சைட் ஒய் சைக்ளோன் இஸ் நாட் ஹேப்பனிங் சார். தட் இன் யுவர் மைண்ட் இட் வில் ஹேப்பன் வென் யூர் ரீடிங் த புக். நவ் யுவர் மைண்ட் வித்வுட் யூ நோயிங் வில் சர்ச் ஆன்சர்ஸ் ஃபார் திஸ். Your mind will always look for answers what it is needing. It is already having some questions. So allow your mind to be working scientifically. Okay? So for that also is very important. And when you read the newspaper, keep the atlas always. Whenever you do not know any meaning in the newspaper, refer the dictionary and write down. A word which is constantly being asked in the newspaper, possibility that this word will come into your life and play a very important role. So, don't you ever take your preparation very lightly. And in your preparation, map is going to play a very, very, very important role. Okay? Now, next. If that is going to be your way of preparation, sir, by reading newspaper, yeah, we can prepare one way, sir. Where is it? Where are you reading, sir? Separately allot time for reading map. Allotting time means every day spend around 10 minutes. It is fun. Map reading is fun. You must know. Just take one part of, maybe if you start with India, just take one Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu le edhaachu sila regions paathute ponga. Map reading la neriya per adhu bayangaramana will within nanichirukalam. Adhella onnum kediyadhu. Adhu sol vittan. Enna sir pananum map reading la? Map therandhu vechittu andha oora paathute andha vaarthaiya sathama unga vaayala sollanum. ஏன் சார்? அந்த ஊர் அங்கதான் இருக்குதுன்னு ஃபர்ஸ்ட் உங்களுக்கு தெரியும். அதுக்கப்புறம் இதே ஊர் நியூஸ் பேப்பர்ல ரெசனன்ஸ் ஆனாலோ, மேபி இந்த டிவி வென் த வேர்ட் இஸ் பீங் அட்டர்ட் பை சம்படி, சம் ஸ்பார்க் வில் ஹேப்பன் இன் த மைண்ட். யா, ஐ ரெட் இட் சம்வேர், தன் யுவர் மைண்ட் வில் பிகன் டு கனெக்ட். ஸோ மேப் ரீடிங் இஸ் வாட்? ஃபண்டமெண்டல் மேப் ரீடிங் மீன்ஸ் ஓபனிங் த மேப் அண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் சீயிங் திங்ஸ். ஸ்லைட்லி அண்ட் அட்வான்ஸ்ட் லெவல் ஆஃப் மேப் ரீடிங் மீன்ஸ் seeing things and one or two data if you already know, connecting the data with the things. And the third level of map reading is seeing things and totally bringing a connection with this and that and that. That is the third level of map reading. Initially, at least the first level of map reading everybody can do in your home, I think. Individually you can sit, maybe 15 minutes you just open in any one area, you can see this map for 15-20 minutes every day at least. After that, maybe you can assimilate one or two friends of like-minded people and say, so this location, I know something. You also prepare something. So, for us say, now you are going to say about northeastern states, you are going to sit for half an hour discussion. Then northeastern states, all you open. Say that tomorrow we are going to discuss northeastern states. So, some points he may generate. He also will generate some points. Then you sit. Then when all are discussing the points about the northeastern states, on that particular day, the four people are going to gain 4-4 information, means all this information accumulated together. You understand this first, second level of map reading. Sir, third level, sir, when all these things have been properly done, sometimes you are going to not sit with somebody of your level of preparation. In a higher level of preparation, you have to sit with these people and you have to discuss. Then he will say, why you are discussing map only geographically? Why not you connect historical point here? like these things, it will happen. This is the advanced level of map preparation.